We give this opportunity to extend my heartiest communion greetings to all Yelangalu members of the August House, as well as to the people of Odisha. This August House has expressed its deep condolences to the sad demise of Lee Kamathuwar Mukherjee, ex-president of India, late Sushila Devi, first ex-Canadian of the state, late Sarat Kumar Kaur, ex-speaker, late Bhakt Prasad Mahatakar, late Sahrai Ram, late Sanatan Rishi, late Sri S.K. Nathpur, our former minister, late Guru Padananda, ex-Ranjan Tejit, late Pradeep Maharati, late Manmohan Gupta, late Vishnu Karandas, all sitting members, late Prahlad Behra, late Veera Sikta, late Vijay Kumar Nayak, late Prashottam Sekhu, late Arjun Charan Sekhu, late Nelson Thoren, late Ramamurthy Mukundan, late Rajendra Nath Ghoi, late Abhinandan Kumar, late Bhutanvi Jena, late Kartikeya Patra, all former members of the Guest House, late Chandrakanta Sadhan, ex-Prime Minister, late Ujjwal Soren, ex-Nayak Sukedar, Indian Army, late Subhir Kumar Tuddu, ex-Army Commando, late Deva Singh Sekhu, ex-Army Commando, and late Bangla Singh Mohammed, ex-Rungara from Odisha Place. I request the honorable member to join me in presenting late Subhir Kumar Mishra, former member of the Guest House, late Vibhuti Gurjumra, ex-Foreign Officer D.D. Assam Raipur, late Vidya Narayan Kaur, ex-SPR, EGR, ex-Junk, 26 Virginia Regiment, Western Command, late Kishan Chandra Panda, ex-Sura, 24 Regiment, and all Corona fighters who have given their life to the service. Guru Deshmukh Professor Kishubhai Corona, the Medical State. Now there being a question of proving the process of the last year, the COVID-19 pandemic has created a high category of school, leading to small damage of population to public health, economy, social, and well-being of community. My government has understood this reality at the very beginning and has been proactively managing the situation as it emerged. Odisha declared the pandemic as a state disaster on 13th March 2020, even before a single case was detected, and took proactive measures to create the educational institution, social gathering, real estate, and etc. Odisha started the lockdown in state on 21st March 2020, before the national lockdown was announced. The lockdown was managed in a smooth manner without any major inconvenience to the general public. The price and force with some security without the certainty to break through. The essential medical supply was thrown in later from source to the last 10 points. My government has also expected to have done with our society in the report that we are sensitive approach to socially with security measures like advanced pensions, various rations, free kitchens, special store to manual sections, etc. were provided. My government recognizes such a large-scale pandemic cannot be managed without involving the panchayat raj institutions in the community. Therefore, sarpanches were empowered under the Vivad se Management Act to enforce and take appropriate measures in the jurisdiction. They were actively involved in COVID management. My government ensures smooth management of India workers returning home from other states due to the pandemic situation. Arrangements were made for the migrant workers in Odisha to return to the states. My government ensured that free quality treatment for the citizens from the testing state to the critical treatment and the discharge. This is one of the main reasons for the low mortality in the state compared to national and internationally mortality rates. To motivate and honor the COVID warriors and to unite the society to fight against the pandemic situation, my government had organized the one way to call genuine and brought together the India approach here. My government has ensured the community participation and management of the COVID situation and large-scale infrastructure in terms of dedicated COVID hospitals, temporary medical camps, COVID care centers, COVID rules and awareness campaigns, involving the PRI and SFG members,
with the cooperation of all, I am happy that today Odisha has successfully overcome the pandemic this week. The state has done extremely well in every parameter of the COVID management and has been praised by national and international organizations for its foresight and effective situation management without any hassle to the public. The mission of my government is to secure Odisha for us every life matters. Working towards the same and to provide equitable and affordable qualitative health care services to all, my government has taken an initiative. Free and assured health care services are now provided at all public health facilities, including and paneled private hospitals under Business Swasthya Kalyan Yojana. Cashless treatment under Business Swasthya Kalyan Yojana, at in paneled private hospitals of Turkey, Pfizer, Park, Bimini, Park, here for a clinically vulnerable family and up to 10 lakh for the human members of the beneficiary economy for over 70 lakh million is provided in the state. Accountability of health professionals in the delivery of health services, transparency and transformation in healthcare services is being ensured through an effective public feedback mechanism as part of the new Sarkar initiative. The health infrastructure in the state is being upgraded and expanded on a large scale. Currently, 5 medical colleges and hospitals and 7 number of specific hospital projects are under construction. The medical college and hospital project is being taken up to expand the primary institution of the AI and the trust institution at the first time, rupees up to 3,500 crores. To make health care services accessible in different areas, has resulted in an increase in people's faith and trust in public health facilities. Many of the facts of my government have been appreciated and acknowledged at various national and international levels. My government has got 3.23 crore beneficiaries belonging to 92.6 lakh families of the state under the national food security cover and providing them with 1.63 lakh metric rice and 23.89 metric wheat per month at an increase of 1 per kg. Besides being our own food security system, 10.98 lakh individuals from 3.63 lakh poor, distressed, eligible and left out families have been covered with 5 kg rice per pence per person per month at the rate of ₹1 per kg. As part of its COVID-19 pandemic management strategy, my government provided additional quantities of rice and dal free of cost for 8 months to state food security scheme beneficiaries and to about 1 lakh migrant workers by last May and June. My government is implementing a transparent, efficient, accountable and robust credit procurement system through continuous reform. By leveraging information and communications technology, my government has prioritized the right of small and marginal farmers to sell paddy to procuring societies and communities. My government has installed 4.7 lakh usual sanitary wells and commissioned 13,055 water supply schemes to provide safe drinking water to the rural areas of the state. During 2020-21, we have already installed 209 solar pumps in hand from tubewells and completed 865 water supply projects along with 637 new private water supply projects. My government has taken up 18 mega private water supply projects with an estimated cost of 3,059 crore under OMVADC, Odisha Mineral Bhat Area Development Corporation funding in 691 villages directly affected by mining in 8 districts of Sundargarh, Meerbhanj, Denkanal, Kolhapur, Yangar, Kangur, Rajgora and Gajpur. Similarly, 9 mega pipe water supply projects have been taken up with an estimated cost of ₹4,157 crores under DMO funds. Odisha has been a leading state in ensuring universal coverage of pipe water supply in the urban areas. Nation has become stressed. Never second without paying 100% water supply tax and followed by striking on the town center. Sugar drinks from tap, we shall provide 24/7 drinkable quality water directly from tap as already been taken up by piloting pressing in rise in the nature and clean. Benefiting 1 billion people. The mission will be expanded to cover other cities and towns. My government has adopted a 360-degree approach to water quality management to ensure that the supplied water meets the necessary quality standards. For this, we have built 78 state-of-the-art NABL accredited water testing laboratory across the state. We have installed over 1,200 iron mineral plants and 640 fluoride mineral plants in two of the process state in areas where groundwater is found to contain traces of iron and fluoride. My government is committed to a time-bound action plan for various measures. Under the broad objective of universal access to drinking water, disaster resilient water supply system, season collective responsive service delivery. My government has been successful in completing a tracking number of houses transparently through a water, monitoring the health, and taking innovative steps like providing incentive to beneficiaries for early completion of household and tagging of filled groceries with specific beneficiaries. During 2020-21, we have completed about 2.8 lakh houses in the region. Secondly, the Swachh Bharat Mission planning has commenced from April 2020. My government has spent around 7,566 lakh individual households lagging. Our state has been declared open application free during September 2019. To ensure universal sanitation access, more than 7.3 million community sanitary complexes have been constructed. State has made a plan to make a shift in solid waste management. Not only a decentralized approach to community management, but a decentralized approach to community management. You have been saying 115 materials in the community, 195 UAVs are now operational for processing more than 60% of the solid waste generated. Converting the waste into wealth in the form of organic waste and recyclable and saleable dry waste. My government targets to process 100% wet and dry waste generated in all the UAVs by end of 2021. Odisha's performance has been recognized nationally. It has been awarded as the fastest moving state in the Swachh Sarvekshan 2020. Besides, six cities of our state have found a place in the top 20 rankings of Swachh Sarvekshan 2020. My government is committed to social security and empowerment of the vulnerable sections, such as persons with disabilities, destitute, disabled, senior citizens, transgender, persons affected by AIDS and special security pension. My state has discovered the highest My government has also made provision for the institution of destitute, athletic, private civil, and transgender under Madhu Babu Pension Yojana. My government has implemented Mamta, the conditional cash transfer maternity benefit scheme in the state, and covered 45% of 30 lakh pregnant and lactating mothers, and has transferred rupees 2,133 crore directly to the beneficiary account. My government has distributed take-home rations, and that's the children's family and the children under supplementary nutrition program.